say nothing about hating his sin. He said, I hate Esau. I don't hate nobody. You and the devil and his mother-in-law is a lie. I'm going to preach her how.
I love it.
13th year. He was 17 years old when the scandal happened. And it happened because he told his brothers, even the wheat sheaves are going to bow to me. Some folk are not happy when you get position. Some folks are not happy when you go up higher. Some folks, he said, that they're crabs in a bucket, but grandfather called them the black buzzard connection. Huh? Buzzards eat dead leftovers because they can't stand to see what eagles saw. Excuse me, let me wrap that again. Yes, he said they were crabs in a barrel, and I like crabs in a barrel, but grandpapa called them the black buzzard connection. Black buzzards eat dead things that are leftovers because they can't stand to see where eagles soar. Eagles fly at an altitude where sometimes they drop their leftovers, and all you got is black buzzards to do this. They look up and they wonder. You got folk that are scandalized because they are upset at your dream. They are mad at your divine future. And yes, we all ought to have aspirations. Somebody shout aspiration.
Aspiration.
We all ought to have divine visions. We all ought to have divine goals. But when you have a dream to where you see yourself in your greater, where you see yourself in your future, where you see yourself doing better than you are, ain't it strange that folk will become mad at you for what you have in your you can't do that. You can't have that. You can't be what you say you can be. We call them haters, but the Bible says it calls them jealousy. The Bible said that hate is the murder, and jealousy is as cruel as the grave. Somebody shout glory. Well, not only did he have a dream where his family would bow to him, where he would be greater, but what they did not see, and let me give you prophetic deliverance, because I happen to be a prophet that just happens to preach. Some of you have been bound up in your family. Stabbed you in the back while it was the person holding your hand. They used to have a song that say, beware of a pat on the back. It just might try and hold you back. Beware of what handshake it does. What it has to say. Say, so God, can I give you some deliverance in here today? Anybody ever wonder why it was your family that was the one to do you in? Anybody ever wonder why it was people close to you that was able to stick you in the back? Look at your neighbor real quick and say, neighbor. You do know Cain killed Abel. Oh, that should have delivered 20 y'all. Y'all missed that. You missed that. Cain was his own brother. And he killed him because his sacrifice is greater. Ain't that crazy, mama? How folk want to kill you because of what you had to give up to get to where you are? They want to kill you because you got a dream. They want to kill you because you have a vision. And so it becomes a scandalous jealousy. And it's sad that how folks can be jealous of what you got on.
What's up?
They may not walk like me, may not talk like me. I know some of y'all say he got on that white suit, but I bet you can't do it like me. You'll catch that tomorrow. I ain't jealous of nothing nobody got, because what God has for me, he is for me. My womb is mine, my talk is mine, my hair is mine, my rings is mine, it's mine. Don't become jealous. And when jealousy abides in the spirit, they wind up with spiritual diarrhea. They walk around making messes everywhere they go, just slipping in mess. Can't never be satisfied. They wind up with the spiritual influenza throwing up on everybody. Everywhere they go, they make a spiritual mess. Y'all know some folks, you might be sitting next to them, don't look at nobody, suffering from spiritual diarrhea. Everywhere they go, you can smell the stench a mile away.
T-shirt.
A scandalous jealousy. But then, not only was it a scandalous jealousy, why was it scandalous? Because his brother sought counsel to kill him. Not only did they want to get rid of him, they said, let's kill him. And so when they got ready to kill him, ain't it a shame they could suck out your life, brother preacher, because you had a dream? More of our young folks have been murdered on the street corner because they had a dream. They wanted to sell crack cocaine because they had a dream. More preachers can't get together and have a congregation because they got preachers underneath them with little dreams. So you got the church to split, to split, to split, to split, to split. So you wind up with division.
Yeah.
Say operations. But I'm here to tell you, don't let devilish distractions stop you from reaching your divine destination. I might as well throw that on you again since I'm preaching real good. Preach black man, no. Preach Carmel man, preacher. Yes, don't let devilish distractions stop you from reaching your divine destination. Folk gonna be mad at you whether you sweet as honey, whether you good as CNH, you can give them $1 million, they still gonna be nasty. Cause they got a scandalous jealousy. You can apologize out of your heart and say I'm wrong. You can get down on your knees and kiss their crusty feet and they still gonna be jealous. Some folks are mad and wired that way. So it became a scandalous journey. Somebody shout scandalous journey. I'm just about done, because I believe some of y'all mad as hell. Don't worry, I'm getting ready to give you some holiness deliverance real quick. Yes. I didn't come to be the most popular. I've been preaching holiness for 21 years, and I guarantee you when you close your eyes, it's going to be one or two things. I'll leave that alone. That's not part of the sermon. That was for free. The scandalous journey. The scandalous journey. You got family members. They say, yeah, go. We behind you. We got your back. Yeah, way back. Way back. The scandalous journey happens when folk get mad because they see where you were going. Yeah. Don't you know that the devil operates in the church because he sees you in your future? Yeah. He knows that God has a plan for you. Yeah. Jeremiah, preach, prophet, talk to me. Jeremiah 29:11, God said, but I know the thoughts that I think towards you. Of evil, but the thoughts of peace and the good and to give you and expecting. Yep. You know why folks get mad at the scandalous journey? They look at you now. They see you in you now, but they don't know where you were and how you got to where you are now. They see you in your glory, but they don't understand your story. They see you shouting and dancing, but they weren't there when you was crying. They weren't there when you were depressed. They weren't there when you were on the horse road. Just about that. But then there was a journey. They sold him in to slavery. Many of the saints of God have been sold in to slavery. We sit in church like ancient mama, bound down with ankle chains. The music can be hot as it want to be. The preacher can be preaching to the sweat and tears of blood. But we become so bound in our spirituality that we can't wave our hands unless his name is T.D. Jakes. We can't not wave our hands unless it's somebody of stature. But you gotta understand that we were sold into slavery. Because when you are not clear about your direction, you will find